Ulwick 60, 1019. Just testing something. Sometimes these streams just crack and get brittle and break, and you need to replace them. So I like to see if I can remove one of them. It looks like there's plastic clips that retained it. So I pull it just like that, not too strong. There's one clip there. I did unclip those two, so let's just keep going. Now it's kind of cold outside, so I'm afraid of breaking, but this is scrapyard, junkyard breakers in it. Well, let's just see what's in the it looks okay. From what I see, these clips, sorry for the camera, so these clips retain the edge here. I think this edge here of that trim, and they have tabs there and there, and you notice already one broke, the two broke here, so you are going to break those tabs. Basically there's no way around, but I wonder if we can replace these guys. Oh yes, I see what happens. Okay, that's nice. Yes, you can replace them. I think there is a part number. I'll try to search when I finish this video, but they go like this, right? Not like that. This starts goes towards the windshield. This is the left side, right? And they basically just slide in. There is a if you notice, there's a gap, and there's metal pins that just slide in there very nicely. Looks like they kind of adjust, but I'm not sure what the reason is. Let's just keep going. But again, you are going to break them. You are going to need one, two. Let's just keep going. The trim itself seems to stay in one piece, so it doesn't really break. It's kind of better not to pull right where the clip is, but more towards the side, maybe towards the, to start with this corner and just work it out and pull maybe on the side of the clip, not straight on the clip. It's mostly aesthetical when this guy's kind of get brittle here, but also I feel like sometimes it depends. If you break these clips, it will just flip flop like this, and when it's windy, it's kind of noisy on the highway mostly. Let me just keep going on and with two hands actually. So got the thing out. It goes all the way from the it's inserted a little bit in there, and then it goes all the way back. Whoa, hold on. And it's just kind of inserts here with this piece. The back one I'm not sure, but I guess it will be pretty much the same. Yeah, it's the same, and you have those different clips. Man, it's really, all the clips seem to be different. Let's just skip for the back one for the moment. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 black clips, one white, and 3 blue ones in the front. Now the blue ones, show you how to remove them, and they break as well. And do this guy here, by the way, notice the positioning, how they are placed. Notice this one, how it's placed. It kind of has a part that goes assigned against that side. So maybe this helps you. But I believe there's no way to remove it without pulling it. It kind of has a small tab right there that you, when you place the new one, you just press against that tab, slide it, and then the tab locks it. So there's no way to remove it from there. But this one didn't break for some reason. Those blue black ones, yeah, some of them did break, but the way to remove them is different. I feel like they have four different clips at least. So that's how you remove them. Notice the positioning, not that way, but this way, and it slides onto that piece there, just like that, kind of, just like that. So if you break one, just, I did manage. Another one. It should just slide like this on the side towards the center of the car, more or less, but with one hand it's harder to do. So anyhow, just slides like this with some force, and the other part stays on the car, the plastic part. There's a base, plastic part stays connected. This is it. The trims have a kind of two spaces for those attaching bar, that for the trick for attaching the bars on the roof. This part didn't really break. No, it stays in one place when you remove it. Maybe that's a chip there, but it's pretty solid. So you can check, get one for the junkyard, and you can replace yours if you need so. All right. I'm not sure about the clips. I'm not going to search this for the part number. Check on fcpeuro.com site. Maybe you can find a part number for this clip. So just ask the Volvo dealer. Again, there are several of them. And the back trim piece. Hold on. This one, it's pretty much the same idea. And let's just see how many clips. One, two, three, four, and I think they are just like the blue ones. You see, there's that tab that's locking the clip, and just hold for the camera to zoom in. Okay, so that clip, you may lift it slightly with something, but when you lift it, it's gonna break anyway, and you should just slide the clip on the side like this. You basically, when you insert the clip, that metal pin comes onto this, under this tab, just press and then slide, and the tab will lock that metal pin, which is welded to the car. And the positioning, again, it looks like this. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope this helps you. Some people are wondering about these trims. Not sure if you can buy them after market or from the main dealer. I'm pretty sure they are going to be a little bit expensive. So it's better to just find the car that has them still intact. And I'm going to have fun today. That's the junkyard, and I'm going to see, when I go to see for cars, Volvos, pretty much there's quite a bit of Volvo A60 here. This one looks really rough because it's on near the entrance, but when you go farther back, they are ones in much, much, much better shape. Let's watch it.